Seated, beloved brothers and sisters. Since these are spiritual sons, who are your relatives and friends, are now to be advanced to the order of deacons, consider carefully the nature of the rank in the church to which they are about to be raised. Strengthened by the gift of the Holy Spirit, they will help the bishop and his priests in the ministry of the word, of the altar, of charity, showing themselves to be servants to all. As ministers of the altar, they will proclaim the gospel, prepare the sacrifice, and distribute the Lord's body and blood to the faithful. Furthermore, it will be their duty, at the bishop's discretion, to exhort believers and unbelievers alike, and to instruct them in holy doctrine. They will preside over public prayer, administer baptism, assist at blessed marriages, bring viatica to the dying, and conduct funeral rites. Consecrated by the laying on of hands that comes down to us from the apostles, and bound more closely to the service of the altar, they will perform works of charity in the name of the bishop or the pastor. With the help of God, they are to go about all these duties in such a way that you will recognize in them that they are disciples of him who came not to be served, but to serve. Now, dear sons, you are about to be raised in the order of the diaconate. The Lord has set an example that just as he himself has done, so also should you do. As deacons, that is, as ministers of Jesus Christ, who came among the disciples as one who served, do the will of God from the heart. Serve the people in love and joy, as you would the Lord. Since no one can serve two masters, look upon all defilement and avarice as serving false gods. Since by your own choice, you present yourselves for the order of the diaconate, you should be men of good reputation, filled with wisdom and the Holy Spirit, as were those once chosen by the apostles for the ministry of charity. As for those among you who will exercise your ministry committed to celibacy, know that celibacy is both a sign of pastoral charity and an inspiration to it, as well as the source of spiritual fruitfulness in the world. Compelled by the sincere love of Christ the Lord, and living in this state with total dedication, you will cling to Christ more easily with an undivided heart. You will free yourselves more completely for the service of God and neighbor, and minister more effectively in the work of spiritual rebirth. Whether or not you have been called to holy celibacy, be firmly rooted and grounded in faith, and show yourselves chaste beyond reproach before God and man, as is proper for the ministers of Christ and the stewards of God's mysteries. Never allow yourselves to be turned away from the hope offered in the gospel. Now, you are not only hearers of this gospel, but also its ministers. Hold the mystery of faith with a clear conscience, expressed by your actions, the word of God which your lips proclaim, so that the Christian people, brought to life by the Spirit, may be a pure offering accepted by God. Then on the last day, when you go out to meet the Lord, you will be able to hear him say, "Well done, good and faithful servant. Enter into the joy of your Lord.